Tonight's opening begins with Jarpur Amber Ale from Brazen Hall Brewing. They describe it as having flavors of caramel, subtle chocolate, some earthy yet fruity notes in the aroma, and a brilliant amber color. Ah, yes, that's nice. What do we have here? It says it is integrated circuits. It kind of makes a noise like it might be. Come back here. Some power TO220 devices. Right. So, what do we have here? 7905. That is a 5 volt negative voltage regulator. Okay, those should be good companions to the 7805 positive 5 volt regulators that I've got. I don't do too much that needs both positive and negative rail, but being able to generate it occasionally and nice and smooth is a bonus. 10 pieces L7905 CV LM7905 voltage regulator IC, 5 volts, 1.5 IC. I don't know what they mean by 1.5. Anyways, the 10 of these cost me $2.47 Canadian, which is a pretty good price, especially given today's, you know, supply chain and all the rest of that. It is just a basic 1 amp negative voltage regulator. Not much else to say about it, really. All right, next in, looks like it came from one of the Canadian reshipping warehouses, so no lies on the outside of the package. Let's see what's inside it. A SanDisk branded 128 gigabyte SD card. If that is a real one, and I'm assuming it is, even though I probably ordered it from China, then that will come in really handy for my various cameras around here. Of course, it could be completely counterfeit. I'm going to have to give it some tests. New camera card, 128 gigabytes memory card, class 10 high-speed memory TF card. I got this at auction for $3.81 Canadian. I was, when I was buying it, skeptical. But if it turns out to be real for that price, that's a hell of a deal. And if it's not, then maybe I can be an object lesson in what not to do for the rest of you. I'm not going to do a full test right now, but I will do just a couple of basic things just to see if it even works at all. So I'm getting it out of the package. It seems like legitimate packaging. I don't know. I'm not that great at telling counterfeits just by looking at them, but the logos look right as far as I can tell. It doesn't look like it's used. There's no skid marks on the plating there. So I'll just connect it up to my little adapter unit here and see what happens when I connect it to the computer. Okay, it shows up. Shows up as 129 gigabyte volume. Interesting. It's formatted as XFAT. Okay. Sure, that looks reasonable enough. So I'm going to copy about 15 gig worth of files onto it and see what happens. Probably should dump a few more onto there, but I'm just going to copy them on there and I'll come back later and see if I can read any of them back. I'll let you know. And while that test is going on, let's see what else is in the mail. This says electronic alarm. Oh, okay. This is a couple of magnetic door switch things for an alarm system. All right. So normally you'd find the reed switch part mounted on the door frame and then the magnet mounted on a door. And when the door closes, it closes the circuit, the magnet causes the reed switch to toggle, and you get a closed circuit. And it looks like about a centimeter or closer is all you really need. So you don't even have to be too precise on these. That's pretty cool. You can find these things in service, in use, anywhere that you need to sense if a window or a door is open or if something is not, you know, in its correct position. Take a look next time you're in like a commercial building, industrial building or something. Take a look on a door, exterior door, just up in the top corner of the door above the doorknob. You'll likely see something like this.
MC38 wire door switch sensor wire magnetic switch home alarm system NC type. Nope, these are not NC, these are NO. Normally closed, no, normally open. These I got for $3.05. That's what they're selling for right now. So yeah, that's what I actually spent on them as well. Well, the price has changed a little bit, $3.05 per set. But still, compared to the usual price for these things, that's not bad. And what else is there to say about them? Well, they're just wrong in their descriptions. You've got to know what you're buying. You can't be trusting these descriptions because they will just, you know, lie to you. No, it's not normally closed, it's normally open. And it sure as hell isn't a voltage regulator.
We're flying right through things today. Next in, it says electronic components. Could be anything. Well packaged, well bubble protected. Oh, there's a chip in there, and well, let's look at the chip first. It is a 7660S. I don't recognize that.
Five pieces, ICL7660, DIP 8 super voltage converter new. Five pieces? There's only one in there. Thinking I was going to get five pieces, I paid $1.36 plus $2.05 shipping for this. I'm going to need to complain to LoveCell 2013. Nothing about it down here in the description, but a quick search for the datasheet shows that it is a CMOS voltage converter. It can convert a 5-volt logic supply to plus and minus 5-volt supplies. That themes well with those regulators I got earlier. Interesting. I did not get the A variant, so the one that I got is capable of dealing with anywhere from 1.5 to 10 volts. So it looks like it's a very low current device, so you're not going to be using it with like a power op amp or something. It looks like, what is this? This is the, if power efficiency drops way off once you get above like 40 or 50 milliamps. Okay. Still could be fun to play with, though. And there is all you need to make it do its thing.
Also in the same package from the same seller, we have a data cable detection board for USB. The instructions in the back say to connect the power supply from the power supply port, insert the data cable into the corresponding port, and four lights are on for normal power, and if it's not, it's abnormal. Right. Oh, C to C type needs 5 lights. Okay.
DT3 data cable detection board, USB cable tester for iOS Android type C. I paid $6.80 for this plus $2.05 shipping. So $10 for the cable tester. That might be interesting. And of course, that came from that same seller. This time they actually delivered what they said they were going to. Not a huge amount down here. It says it uses 1 amp of output current. Not quite sure. Maybe it's running current through and seeing if there's a voltage drop or something. I'm not sure. Doesn't seem to have much other than some LEDs and resistors on the board, but I guess we can play with it.
So here we go. We've got a power in USB-C, and then we got a type A, a couple of type Cs, a micro, and a lightning. And there are the LED showing whether VCC ground, data plus, data minus, and the CC line, which is, I guess, part of the type C. Let's play with this thing. It looks like it wants a USB type C for power feeding into it. All right. Let's see what happens. Nothing so far. Right. Let's plug in a USB type A to micro. Oh, that's too short to get around there. Okay. How about a type C to type C then? That's not a type C, that is. Okay, so it says that's good. It says all 5 lights are on. Cool. Let's see what else I've got here. How about this type A to, what are we, micro? And again, 4 lights, which is correct. I guess that's good for a quick go, no-go anyway. Let's see what this one does. I think that, yeah, that one is power only. As you can see, there's no data on it. So that one is a charge-only cable. So I guess if you got some of those in your collection slash accumulation of cables, this would be good to quickly sort out which are which. or if they're just broken or intermittent or something, I suppose. It's a very low-tech device, but for fairly cheap, what is it, $6 plus shipping, that's going to come in handy, I think. And the last item in, this calls itself electronic components. Fully vague, I love it. What do we got here? DuPont wires. Two bundles of DuPont mail-to-mail wires. The only thing remarkable about these is that they've got the round soldered-on ends, molded-on ends, rather than these square crimped-on ends. And the mail-to-mail cables are the ones that I use the most. These are kind of annoying. They bend. They don't... they're not the best connector. I mean, none of these little DuPont-style jumpers are the best connector in the world, but for prototyping or tinkering around, they're just fine. But I much prefer to use this style here. So, I ordered a bunch.
2/5/10 pieces of 65 pieces mail-to-mail flexible solderless breadboard jumper wires cable. These were $210 for a single bundle of 65. I got two bundles for $411 and $2 shipping, so pretty good deal all in all. And again, these are essentially a consumable, but they are super handy to have around for all your breadboard tinkering needs.
And there we have the results of today's Mailbag Monday haul extravaganza, opening, whatever you want to call this thing. Some useful stuff, some utilitarian stuff, just generally interesting as usual. This tester, well, probably, I mean, it's the same test you could do with a multimeter if you get a multimeter onto the terminals of a USB connector, so this just makes a nice little breakout, and it does have breakout test points on the board as well, so that could just come in handy just for that purpose to measure voltages and stuff on a connector. Also got two different ways of generating negative voltage supplies, a high current one and a low current one. That's kind of cool. These MEG switches I'm intending to use on the doors of my garage. And I'm not quite sure whether that's going to be an Arduino or ESP8266 project or just something a bit more mundane from that. We'll see. General stock of consumables as usual. And then this, I still don't know if it's a legitimate one or if it's a scam one. The fake ones, the scam ones, often have much lower capacity, and when you start dumping files onto them and then try to read them back, it just fails. So that's why I'm throwing several gigs of video files onto it, and we'll see. I'll update you later. Actually, let's go and see how it's doing right now.
So with all these files copying, and I added 8 more after I paused when you saw this last, it's going to take hours and hours, and I'm not going to stick around here and hold the video up for that long. I may edit in some results later on, but it looks like it's copying them, as far as I can tell. The file system thinks that there's 4.7 gigs crossed so far. But I am just going to let that finish, and I'll update you eventually.
Yeah, I'll put an update in the description, I think, once I fill this thing. And I think I am going to, I'll fill it from here, as much video as I got here. Then I'll take it up to my editing computer and dump a whole bunch of bigger files onto it. I'll see if I can fill it right up, and then try and retrieve some of the files. I'll let you know. Anyway, that was a lot of fun. As usual, not the most outlandish stuff this time, but sometimes you just got to get utilitarian stuff too. Anyway, thanks for watching. As always, thanks to my Patreon supporters and my YouTube channel members for helping keep the lights on, helping keep the beer fridge full, and helping to keep the mailbags rolling in. If you've got anything to say about any of this, down in the comments section as usual. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.
Addendum. After a couple of hours, it has finished, so I'm just going to eject it and plug it back in. So that should flush any temporary files that are holding it. There it is again. Okay, let's just pick a random file here and play it. And it seems to be playing just fine. Excellent. Try a couple more. Yeah. So it seems that it didn't do what some of those fake cards do, is, you know, just dump everything into a hole and pretend it's copying it. It actually seems to have copied the files across properly. Well, that is pretty neat. That one seems to be working too. Cool. Okay. So I think my gamble paid off. That is excellent. Thanks for sticking around. I'll talk to you later.